Do you think drone technology is going to play a role? Will that also be because, you know, unmanned aerial vehicle is already out there. Manned one are in progress. There are wonderful startups in Munich area working on that. So they're saying that the future luxury will be your private jet. What do you think of that?
Sure. I think for some people, I mean, today some people, they have private yachts and jets and helicopters and soon spaceships.
Well, what do they actually mean is that they will be, if they mass produce,
for the masses,
they'll be able to produce, like, you know, you can buy a vehicle.
I'm happy to go on the record and be proven wrong one day. Yeah. I don't really see it happening. I mean, I think there will definitely be a use case. I think there will definitely be a market for some autonomous drones shuttling people around some places, sure. Do I think it's going to replace other modes of transit? No way. If only for basic physics. I mean, it would be really annoying to have a bunch of things buzzing around, producing all this downwash from rotors. I mean, that would just be annoying. So if only for that, I just don't see it happening. But besides that, I just, it's another layer of complexity that I think is kind of unnecessary. In contrast, I think it's a lot easier a solution to solve autonomous cars generally on the road, platooning together, perfectly optimized to get from A to B. And indeed, when I say optimized, never being empty. So even if that requires then the usage of the big T word, taxes, an occupancy tax, right? So if you've got an empty pod car driving around, not carrying passengers, you should be heavily taxed, penalized, fined, whatever you want to call it. But there's precedent for this, right? At least in the US, and I think, actually, I don't know if in Germany you have the idea of carpool lanes or if you get reductions for tolls. So in the US, you have these carpool lanes where, well, if you've got a passenger, it's free, and if you don't have a passenger, you pay more, or you can't be in the lane at all. So there is precedent for occupancy generally. So you mandate this stuff, and the optimal solution, the optimal end game is a bunch of autonomous cars platooning together, always with at least one or two occupants.
Uber has an interesting vision on that. They want to do both. They want to go all in autonomous
vehicles. Do all the things.
And also on drones.
That's
and
fine.
And stuff. And probably the future will be a combination
sure,
of both.
Yeah.
And as you said, zero occupancy. Yeah. You take people from one part to the other.
Also, as a startup guy, you know what I always say? Try all the things.
Try all the
things. See what works.
See what works.
If you can afford it, do it.